Hello, everyone. I would like to introduce you to the Wide Area Personal Alert System, otherwise known as WAPA. Our team consisted of Anushka, Marcos, Karan, and Steph. Our project was sponsored by Mark, a civil engineering student at the University of Alberta. We brought the vision to life under the guidance of Dr. Knudsen and following the project description provided by Mark and his team. Our system aims to facilitate the communication between people and emergency services through a small, affordable, and easy-to-use device, where the user can pair the device to the phone with our app just through a few taps and have their emergency contacts just a button click away. The WAPA system was built with well-known and supported services. It stores the user-identifiable information and contact information, and the app is responsible for reaching out to the emergency contacts and passing along this information without the need of a phone call. While the notification device, also known as ND, consists of a capable SoC or system-on-chip that handles relaying of the alert signal to the phone through just a press of a button. Once received, the phone then reacts to the alert signal by sending out a message to the user's emergency contacts alongside any necessary user's identifiable information. Let's take a look at our key expectations, which included unique identification of wearable device, allowing unique association of the device with its owner. Second, we wanted secure collection and storage of the user's information in a database. Third, we wanted end-to-end communication, so our wearable notification device would use a BLE stack to communicate with the user's smartphone and send an SMS to the emergency contact smartphone. And we wanted to do all of this in a range of 100 meters. As an outcome of our project, we successfully achieved the core functionalities outlined in the walking skeleton, enabling SMS notifications to be promptly dispatched to our users' emergency contacts via their phone, triggered by alerts from the wearable device, even from distances up to 130 meters. Not only did we meet this crucial milestone, but we also surpassed the expectations in terms of device range and battery life, ensuring prolonged and reliable operation. Additionally, our app's capabilities allowed us to accurately pinpoint the location of our device user, enhancing the effectiveness of our system. Now let's delve deeper into the intricate workings of our project.
Taking a look at how our app works, when the user opens the app, they are first prompted to either log in or register. Upon starting the registration process, the user is prompted to enter their first name, last name, email, and a password. Lastly, before the user can finish the registration process, they are required to enter a few personal details, including their date of birth, phone number, driver's license, and health card number. Once registered, the user can now sign into their account and access the app. Within the app, the user can then go to their settings to add emergency contacts, as well as edit or remove any existing ones. The user is also able to change their login details as well as medical info from the settings. Once the user is set up, they can now go and pair a device. We'll now show a quick demo of a user signing into the app and pairing their notification device. To pair a device, the user will navigate to the Add a Device section. On the screen, a few instructions will be displayed. The user can click the Add a Device button and is prompted to search for devices. The user is then able to connect their WAPA notification device and can confirm their device is connected by looking at the corresponding LED light. The user is now able to use the button on their notification device to send an automated text message to registered emergency contacts. Emergency contacts will receive a text message with the location, driver's license, and health card numbers of the registered user.
A bit of a deep dive in the software components of our project. Other than the Android Studio app UI that we can see, we're also using Firebase for our database. In the database, we're storing users' profile, including their users' identifiable information, as well as the device info, and users' emergency contact info. And here, they're all linked by the user's email.
Let's take a look at the ND now. The ND is comprised of the NRF52840 SoC because of its present BLE stack and a simple processor to program. It also includes a battery holder for coin cell batteries, a button to trigger an alert, and two LEDs to indicate the status of connectivity and notification receiving within the app. The ND can respond to two different button sequences, a triple click or a hold. When the button is pressed thrice, a simple emergency contact notification is sent that requests the emergency contact to come to your current location. Well, if the button is pressed, the ND sends a different message that notifies the emergency contact to reach out to emergency services with the appropriate information appended to the message. When an alert is received from the ND, the application will then read the signal value from the BLE stack through the Android BLE API. And from there, we will proceed to extract the signal type, which will either be a triple press or a hold, and start generating the appropriate message according to the signal read. The app itself will then reach to the backend to process the alert received, where it will retrieve appropriate information from the database, such as the emergency contact information and the user's identifiable information, such as the driver's license number, health card number, and location, before sending it off to the emergency contact.
The Fuse Location Provider, a component of Google Play Services that intelligently combines GPS, Wi-Fi, and cellular data to provide the most accurate location possible. Given the complexities of indoor and urban environments where GPS signals can be unreliable, we opted to use network-based location data. Our approach, enabled by the fine location permission, allowed us to achieve higher accuracy in such scenarios, ensuring that our application remained functional and reliable under various conditions. We established a location callback to manage incoming location updates. Through the on-location result method, we were able to process the location data, focusing on the longitude and latitude, which were vital for our application's functionality. When our app receives a signal from the ND, it triggers an alert and sends a JSON request containing the sender's number, the receiver's number, and the message content to our API gateway hosted on AWS. The API gateway authenticates and authorizes the request before routing it to a specific AWS Lambda function. This function processes the JSON, extracting the necessary details and reformats them for Twilio's API. It then calls the Twilio Send SMS API, providing the necessary details. Finally, Twilio sends a message to the receiver's phone number.
Throughout the project, we were able to meet our milestones successfully, but not without some difficulty along the way. We were successful in pairing the ND and the phone over long distances, where we tested in various different environments to check for reliability. This included scenarios where we tested purely long distance of around 130 meters, and were successful. We also tested with varying different obstacles, such as floors and hills, where we were able to, on average, reach our goal of around 100 meters. For the device, we also succeeded in establishing an input feedback loop, where on click, the device would successfully send the emergency signal to the phone. We also succeeded in making the device's expected lifespan to be around 2 years by using a battery-efficient SoC and a well-constrained coin cell battery. While from the app side, we succeeded in storing the user's identifiable information and contact information so we can send this to emergency contacts. The app was ultimately successful in reading in and responding to the stress signals sent by the device, where it was able to reach out to the user's emergency contacts with a quick text message alongside their identifiable information. While some of the challenges we faced included maintaining a stable connection in certain environments, as Bluetooth connections are susceptible to obstacles and other signal interference, where based on the environment the device is found within, there could be potential disconnects. These were handled with a persistence method on the app side, where the app continues to try to reconnect while the service is alive on the phone. Another significant delay that we encountered in our progress was due to the handling of the BLE interface on the app. When setting up a listener on the app side, it required initial queries to the device prior to being able to listen to emergency notifications. And this was not explicitly mentioned or documented in the official documentation for the BLE API. We also encountered accuracy issues using the built-in GPS module of the phone, so we ended up switching over to a Fuse location provider through Google Play Services API. One of the last challenges we encountered was due to the asynchronous nature of the querying between the device and the phone, where we would have queries overlapping each other, especially in the setup phase, where we would query twice in quick succession and they would end up overriding each other. We managed to handle the issue by forcing a wait on the start of the connection between the phone and the device, where we would wait for the initial query to return before continuing to query a second time.
As a part of our ongoing enhancements, we aim to expand the functionality of the wearable notification device to establish a wide area network. The wide area network can be utilized by the users to notify others in the vicinity of hazardous situations, such as a confrontation occurring on campus. Additionally, in the event of a user's phone being stolen, their notification device can still dispatch alerts to emergency services and contact emergency contacts via another user's phone connected to the wide area network.
From a technical standpoint, the user's devices with the app installed will act as an endpoint for the network. The app will be able to receive notifications from other devices within a 100 meter radius. The user can choose whether or not they want to receive messages from the wide area network. An alert received from another ND can be of two different severities, informational and emergency alert. Informational alerts will contain messages from other users trying to send a caution message to those on the wide area network, while the emergency alert will mean another user is in a state of emergency, so the ND will ask for permission to use another user's phone to contact emergency contacts and emergency services.
We have three primary suggestions for future hardware improvements. First, we propose the addition of an inertial measurement unit to enable automatic fall detection as well as tap detection. This will allow us to remove the button, leading to a sleeker, more weatherproof physical design. We also suggest the addition of a buzzer to provide auditory feedback in case the user is unable to see the wearable. Finally, we propose implementing the system on a printed circuit board to allow us to decrease the size, weight, and cost of the system. Overall, the project was successful, with our prototype achieving the required functionality. However, our prototype did fail to meet the performance requirements regarding size and weight of the final prototype, which was supposed to have a footprint no larger than a loonie and a weight of less than 50 grams. During testing, our final prototype achieved end-to-end communication from the user to the wearable via button press, from the wearable to the user smartphone using Bluetooth Low Energy, and finally from the user smartphone to the emergency contact smartphone using an automated SMS message. We were able to successfully transmit messages over BLE from the wearable to the user's phone up to 130 meters away. Altogether, the project successfully demonstrates feasibility of smartphone-enabled wearable notification devices.
Thank you.